and good evening. Here is the Lagos State News at 7. I am Akam Hussein. Lagos State government has declared tomorrow, 20th of August, a work-free day in commemoration of this year's Isheshe Day. This was contained in a circular signed by the state's head of service, Bode Agoro. According to the circular, Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu approved the work-free day to give necessary support to traditional institutions, as well as enhance the promotion of indigenous tradition by preserving cultural heritage. The government in the circular enjoined all traditional worshippers and citizens to use the day to pray for the peace, unity, and stability of the state in particular and the country in general. Workers are expected to resume their duty post on Wednesday, 21st of August, by 8 o'clock in the morning. Meanwhile, the Ogun and Osun state governments have also declared tomorrow to be a work-free day to celebrate Isheshe Day. In a vibrant display of cultural exchange and heritage preservation, the Lagos State government proudly supported the 2024 Sango Festival in Oyo State. Chief Executive Officer of the Lagos State Council for Arts and Culture, Ido Johnson, led a team of officials to witness the grand celebration, which took place from August 8 to 17 at the Festival Arena, Aragon, Oyo State. The festival was a spectacular showcase of the rich cultural heritage of the Yoruba people, featuring stunning dance displays, including the Eyo Masquerade performance by the Lagos State Cultural Troupe. The Sango Festival, enlisted by UNESCO in 2023, marks the beginning of the Yoruba traditional New Year in August and involves ancestral worship, chanting, storytelling, drumming, and dancing. It is an expression of shared identity and social cohesion. The Lagos State Traffic Management Authority, LASMA, has apprehended a trailer driver involved in a hit-and-run incident at Antonio K heading towards Oshodi. The driver was apprehended after hitting a pedestrian who was attempting to cross the expressway near the Total Filling Station at Antonio K. The incident, which occurred in the early hours of Monday morning, sparked significant concern among witnesses and commuters. The pedestrian, who sustained a serious injury, including a broken left leg, was promptly attended to by personnel from the Lagos State Ambulance Service, Los Ambos, and transported to a nearby hospital for urgent medical treatment. LASMA officials on duty at the time responded swiftly, pursuing the fleeing driver and apprehending him at Oshodi. He has since been handed over to officers from Musafejo Police Station for further investigation and prosecution. LASMA reiterated its commitment to ensuring the safety and security of all road users in Lagos. Lagos State Commissioner for Transportation, Oluwaseun Oshiemi, has charged the Lagos Ferry Services to adequately utilize the assets it has to generate the revenue needed for the state, noting that the environment, ambience, and efficiency of the agency's boats were critical to driving more traffic to the ferries. Oshiemi stated this at a three-day management retreat organized by the Lagos Ferry Services, LAG Ferry, to explore strategies for harnessing the economic potentials of Lagos waterways to boost revenue, promote sustainable practices, and contribute to the state's economic growth. Oshiemi, who was represented by the Permanent Secretary, Minister of Transportation, Olawale Musa, noted that the passenger experience is very important for people to keep using the service, stating that every process of boarding the boats, from using the cowrie cards for payment to their experience while on board and disembarking, must be memorable. Earlier in his welcome address, Managing Director of LAG Ferry, Abdulbak Balogun, highlighted the agency's achievements, including a significant increase in fleet size, routes, and passenger numbers. He emphasized the importance of leveraging waterways assets to improve revenue performance and contribute to the state's economic growth. The Lagos State government has emphasized the critical need for compassion, empathy, and action in addressing global challenges. Commissioner for Women Affairs and Poverty Alleviation, Bolaji Dada, highlighted the significance of humanitarian efforts, particularly in the context of poverty alleviation and the empowerment of women. At an event to commemorate the World Humanitarian Day with the theme, No Matter What, Humanitarians Deliver, Dada stressed that women, who often make up the majority of those living in poverty, she'll be at the forefront of humanitarian interventions. The commissioner called on governments, organizations, and individuals to come together, transcending boundaries and ideologies, to prioritize human dignity above other things. She also called for collective action to support those facing hardship, including conflict, displacement, and inequality, noting that the response to these challenges defines the strength of our societies. Dada paid tribute to the countless aid workers, community leaders, and activists who continue to work tirelessly in the face of adversity. The Lagos State government is optimistic of reduction in the prices of food items and other consumables within the shortest period of time, following the distribution of farm inputs to all categories of farmers and agro-processors across the state. To this end, the state government has appealed to residents to increase their involvement in subsistence farming towards self-sufficiency, job creation, and food security. Commissioner for Agriculture and Food Systems, Abisola Olusonya, expressed this optimism at the official flag-off and symbolic presentation of agricultural inputs and productive assets to the full-cycle beneficiaries at Oko Oba area of Agege. She made it known that about 10,000 farmers would cut across fishermen, agriculture, poultry, piggery, vegetable farmers benefited from the fourth cycle distribution of farm imputes. The commissioner said symbolic presentation of agricultural imputes and productive assets were to force down the prices of food when the produce was sold in the market. Olusoya noted that the program was a collaboration between the federal and state government and the World Bank under the COVID-19 Action Recovery Scheme. Just before we go, slow down at road junctions, intersections, and pedestrian crossings. You can follow us and like all our various social media platforms on X Traffic Radio 961, Facebook Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1 FM, Instagram Lagos Traffic Radio 961. On YouTube, subscribe and watch us live on our channel, Traffic Radio 961. You can also visit our website on www.trafficradio961.ng. Did you know that the Sanwo-Olu administration provided 450,000 pupils with e-learning devices? You can get more details on the Lagos State Government website. For contact with the newsroom, please send a message to info@trafficradio961.ng. And that ends the news broadcast compiled by Adirayo Idowolaya. I am Akan Usen. Thanks for listening and please stay safe. Good evening.